Good evening, Bill Kennedy, 1834 Ontario Avenue, also a candidate for city council. In walking the streets recently, I've met with tons of residents, and I told them that I would voice a lot of their general concern, one of them being cut down trees and stumps. And I'm just wondering if there's any plan in place to grind some of these stumps and trees that are just waiting for accidents to happen. Some of them have been there 5, 6 years, people I've known for a while, just wondering if there's anything in place to help alleviate that situation.
Yeah, we are, that's the motion. We just approved funding for the last meeting.
I told them I would say it, so here I am.
Can't hear you. Just approved funding our last meeting.
There's going to be also priorities, if I may, Chairman. We have both in-house and a contractor working on it, so it'll double up how many things are going to be.
Okay, there's a few residents that have, like, and I've known them my entire life, they tell me, like, Bill, this stump's been here for 5 or 6 years, so I'm just, you know. Earlier this year, we fought the governor on the lodge at Goat Island, and it got me to thinking, what do we have in place to protect the gorge? Do we have anything to protect? So if there is something, I believe that we need it to be updated, so that there's no commercialization or any type of, you know, buildings and things like that near or in the gorge. If there's not, we need to make a resolution to protect the gorge, because if they're thinking about the Goat Island, we're thinking about Goat Island, they're going to be thinking about other places too. So to preserve the beauty of what we have, I'd like to see something put in writing, or like I said, a resolution to protect the gorge. One of the big things, obviously, you've spoken about tonight is we have a budget crisis. You can sugarcoat it all you want, we have a budget crisis. How do we fix it? We need to start fighting for what is ours. Niagara Falls has 8 million visitors that come here every single year, if not more. And if each one of them spends about $100 or more, that's $800 million. Somewhere in the vicinity of $1 billion is probably spent. Where's our share? We need to stop fighting for it. Look at Canada, they have $1 billion, they don't have any issues. We gotta stop being treated like we're an afterthought in the state of New York. We have to fight for what is ours. The city needs it, the people need it, and we all want it. We all need it. And then just to touch on a couple other things, Uber, just so that everybody knows, insurance is required, a background check is required, and if I may suggest to all of you, let the state of New York take care of it, because I am a professional driver, I am signed up for Uber, and I had to go through the background check, and I had to go through the insurance, I had to provide copies of everything for them to see, for them to approve me to actually work. And the other thing is that I get to make myself available in the areas that I want to drive. I can drive Niagara Falls if there's clients, I can drive in Buffalo if there's clients, I can drive in Syracuse, Albany, New York City, wherever I want, as long as all that was provided and I did and I'm cleared and I'm ready. The track team, awesome, thank you. I ran track at Niagara Falls High School, class of 93. I was a power cat. I was on that track team. I would love to help. And just on a side note, can any of you stop the rain? Thank you.